Yippee-yi-yay.
Hey there, YouTube. It's Robdor yet again. Today I bring you an exciting milestone video. Why do I say that? Because this is the day the longest and hardest Let's Play challenge I've encountered will end. One way or another, I'm finishing Gunsmoke today. Fuck yeah! You get to witness it! Alright, let's dive right into the last level here. I don't know how I'm gonna do this level very easily, but you know. So I want these items. Ah, shit, I wanted to get down there before the brown shirt started really coming out in force, yeah. Yeah, see, I want to kill as many of those brown shirts as I can from down there, because that's the only way I'm going to be able to survive. So those brown shirts are gonna pose a huge problem later, as I cross over the bridge and they shoot me from behind like that. See, I got the right idea. I just need faster execution, I think. Okay, let's throw in a credit. Ah, that piano music. How I love it and loathe it at the same time. Love it because of the way it sounds. Loathe it because of what it means. Ah, damn it. What the fuck? What the fuck? Why did my controller go wonky? Ah, fucking hell. Okay, well, my controller is fixed up here. Make sure of it. What the shit? Okay, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna pause the video here. There we go. For some reason, I don't even know why, my computer felt the need to reinstall my controller drivers and my controller kept treating as if it was unplugging and plugging back in. So yeah, that kind of fucked me over this life. And the life before that, but whatever. It's my death. My death's entertainment. Let me be your martyr, I say. Fuck this game. This game does... Like, I don't need a fucking handicap. This game's fucking brutal enough without one. Yeah, that was stupid. I crossed over at the wrong place there. Well, maybe not. Let's look at this. Those guys go away. Yeah, that's actually not a bad strategy right there. Stay at the top of the screen and murder the purple guys as they come out. Get the dynamite guy, get the purple guy. Some brown shirts to go away. Yeah, this is actually kind of feasible. Maybe not. I didn't say it was perfect, I just said it was feasible. Didn't even see that bullet hit me, but whatever! I don't care, I'm in too good of a mood to be brought down by this game, because I will finish it. I don't care how. I don't care how long it takes. I don't care how much off-screen footage, or fast-forwarding, or any other gimmick I have to use. This game is going down like a $2 whore on payday today. Oh man, this is getting nuts. Ah, shit, I almost had enough room to go back down to the bottom there. Still, what a strategy to work. I wanted to kill him. Fuck. It was my own fault. I took too long trying to focus on dynamite faggot there. Okay. Cross over. Worry about him. There we go. I was about to say, he'll go down like a ton of bricks anyway. Ah! Right in the head! Okay, well, I'm going to try to implement my brilliant strategy in a speed play here, speed montage here. Be right back! Okay, so it seems I downed one of the Wingate boys before I even realized I was fighting the Wingate boys. Good to know that two out of three of them don't fight like regular bosses. I also love the sinister music. Holy... Whoa! Holy shit. This is the kind of boss that I like fighting. It's very bullet hell. If only he didn't have fucking goons with them, this would be actually... Holy shit. And he gets down on the ground like that, like the first boss. Wow. Holy shit! I beat it without a fucking speed up montage! Yes! Wow! I was not expecting to beat that guy without a speed up montage. Holy fuck, that was amazing! Wow, that was so shitty! Happy, happy, very happy! Peace has finally returned to this town. However, the bandits will probably return again to attack the town. Yes, Bella's battles have just begun to fight for continued peace in this town. Thank you for playing this game to the end. Look forward to enjoying Capcom's next exciting game. Thank y'all again. Wow, this game actually has an ending of sorts. I wasn't even expecting that, really. Oh, wow, and you just get game over. You don't have to restart this fuck heap from the beginning. That's impressive. Let's immortalize this with a classier form of last name, even though it's not number one. Fuck yeah. Rob is the message. All right, well, I thank everyone for witnessing that. Whenever anyone says that I've killed the last boss, who should have been harder than any of the other bosses, on one life! I never died on him once! There you go. You've witnessed it. Music here, well, yeah, sadly I didn't get to use the second half of my music montage, which was the Cowboys from Hell by Pantera. You knew that. You fucking know that song. Everyone does. My intro music is interesting. You probably recognize the song Ghost Riders in the Sky. But what you may not know is that was a version done by Marty Robbins, the man who brought us Big Iron and El Paso and so much other amazing cowboy-themed country music. The end credit theme, as you'll hear, is speaking of Marty Robbins, is one that any Fallout New Vegas fan should recognize if you've had the radio on in that game for more than 5 seconds, and that would be the iconic epic tune Big Iron by Marty Robbins. All right, where do I go from here? I'll be honest, I have no fucking idea what I'm doing next for a Let's Play. I've got several ideas floating around. I'm not going to mention any, just because if I mention them and then play something completely different, I'll seem like an asshole. But please, if anyone has any suggestions, send them in. Email me at elbedocardo@gmail.com. I know I check it. I don't know if Kat and the rest of them do. I check that fucking email address every day. Message us on YouTube. We like comments. We like messages. We want more of them. Look me up on Facebook, Robert Chase. Very hard man to find. Follow us on Twitter. Twitter at albendocardo. Just at albendocardo. I don't update that nearly as much as I should, but I don't have enough followers to justify it. More of you need to follow me. Then maybe I'll be forced to update more often. All right, well, once again, thanks for witnessing this impossible journey from start to finish. I'm going to go finish my coffee and while I edit this video and post it. Have a good one.
To the town of Alfrey rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early.